Please make a note of the problem statement. A tetrahedron, of 55 millimeter sides rests on one of its corners, such that, an edge containing the corner, is inclined to HP at, 50 degrees, and VP at 30 degrees. Draw its projections. A tetrahedron of 55 millimeter sides rests on, one of its corners, such that, an edge containing the corner is inclined to HP at 50 degrees and VP at 30 degrees. See, I think in the first class, when I have given introduction to the solids, so I also given the description of a tetrahedron. Basically, a tetrahedron is a solid which is bounded with the four equilateral triangular faces. Okay, so four equilateral triangular faces, and such type of solid we call it as a tetrahedron. Okay. So now we are just moving into the another one, the solid, what we call it as a tetrahedron. So where we need to project when the tetrahedron has been placed in a, with reference to the reference planes, in a different positions. So this is a one such problem what we are having is a tetrahedron having a side of 55 millimeter sides rests one of its corners such that the edge containing the corner is inclined to HP at 50 degrees and 30 degrees. So this is the problem what they have given. See, we have only two problems on tetrahedron for this solution manual, and two problems on hexahedron or a cube. So this is any one of these problems we keep on repeating in your examination. So please practice this very simple problems. Only two problems are there on tetrahedron. Okay. So as I told, tetrahedron is basically a solid which is bounded with the four equilateral triangular faces. So now such solid has been placed on HP with one of its corners, and the edge containing that corner is inclined to HP as well as inclined to VP at 50 degrees and 30 degrees respectively. So now how to get the projection of such kind of solid? So when we say tetrahedron, so it is made with the equilateral triangular faces. There are four equilateral triangular faces. Okay, so here when you want to construct the tetrahedron, so the condition is it is resting on HP with one of its corners, so therefore the when you construct a tetrahedron in the initial position, so first you have to start with an equilateral, constructing an equilateral triangle of 55 millimeter side. So construct an equilateral triangle of 55 millimeter side such that the corner should come to your right. The corner of a triangle, equilateral triangle, should come to your right. You have to construct in such a way, right? So this is the initial position. So look at here, the tetrahedron. First, you have to construct an equilateral triangle of 55 millimeter side with the small one of its corners. So after constructing an equilateral triangle, then you have to construct or you have to join all their triangular faces, because base will be a triangular face. Apart from the base equilateral triangular face, there are other three equilateral triangular faces. All these equilateral triangular faces will meet at a common point. We call it as an apex again, similar to that of the pyramid, right? So now, in the case of a tetrahedron, so you have to join the slant edges. So slant edges in the sense, so you have to draw the medians of a triangle. So median of a triangle in the sense, which joins the corner to the midpoint of the opposite edge. So because it has got three equilateral triangular faces, so you will have three medians. So all these three medians will represent the slant edges of a tetrahedron. So now you have to draw the three medians. So you have to join from the corner A. So because A, B, C, D is the equilateral triangular face which represents the base of a tetrahedron. Now you will go to draw the slant edges of an equilateral tetrahedron. So from A, you have to draw a median, okay? So that it will go into be drawn from the corner A to the midpoint of the opposite edge, which is BC. So we draw with a thin line first. All the three medians you draw from each corner. Then, so you have to make the line thick, which represents the slant edges, only from the corner to the intersection of the three medians. A point where three medians will go into intersect. So till that, the line has to be made as a thick line. So that represents the slant edge of a tetrahedron. So the remaining line from the point of intersection to the midpoint of the opposite edge, you can erase it. And this is the final top view of a tetrahedron, which is resting on one of its corners of the base on HP. I think you can understand this. So tetrahedron is an equilateral triangle, four equilateral triangular faces, a solid bounded with four equilateral triangular faces. So when you are constructing a tetrahedron, first construct an equilateral triangle of a given dimension, given 54 millimeters. Then you can, after constructing, you have to join the slant edges by drawing the medians. So this is what we call it as the top view of a tetrahedron, which is just one HP with one of its corners of the base. So once you get this, the next thing is you have to get the front view of this. So for front view, what you're supposed to do, you draw the vertical projectors from the each point A, B, C, D, at the point where the three medians will meet. That point we call it as an O at the apex, and O1 is at the center of the base. So O1 represents the axis of the tetrahedron, right? So after that, you just project it to the front view. So draw the vertical lines till the XY. So now, after drawing where all these projectors will meet, so please see projector A, where it touches the intersects at X line, so it is A dash, and the two edges B and C, and B and C, B dash and C dash, the front view you can mark. So this is first you mark. Then what you have to do is the projector from the axis point. So when you draw the projector axis point, you just project it beyond X length. Yes, beyond that. Project the axis point. So from the O, you are drawing the projector line in the XY line. From XY line, project beyond XY to a certain. Okay. So now what you have to do is you have to take a compass. Starting from you have a compass is very important. It is not as that pyramid is from the pyramid construction in the front view. Please listen carefully. Okay. So what initially, I will just repeat once again, what you're supposed to do when you draw the front view of a pyramid in the equation. From that top view, you draw the vertical projectors to the XY. Right? So So the points, so projector from A, it represents A dash. Projectors from B and C, it represents B dash and C dash. And also the projectors from the axis, which is O dash. So O dash will be lying on the base. So there is one O dash. You don't know it is O dash. Okay. So for the properties, you have to project the axis. You draw a thin, very thin line above the XY line. Above the XY line. Now, now what you have to do is after that, so you have to project the projector of the axis beyond XY line to locate the point O dash. So where is the point O dash is? So point, you take a compass, okay? So from the compass, you just measure the distance for 50 millimeters. So you have to 55 millimeters set. So in the sense, what they have given is 55 millimeters, right? So set the radius of the compass equal to 55 millimeters. So now you have to select the point A dash. Why I am selecting the point A dash? Because see, A dash A is the corner. So you have to select from the corner only. The corner point where you are having the edge OA, the slant edge OA is parallel to the XY, there is VP and HP. So therefore, the only OA is the true length of this slant edge that can be obtained in the front view. So therefore, always start with the corner point. Don't go with the edge points for the XY line. So start with the corner point. So because only the slant edge starting from the corner A, so that is OA. OA is the slant edge which is parallel to both HP and VP, which is parallel to HP and VP. So then you're going to have the true length. You can see the true length of the slant edge only, that is OA. So therefore, from the corner, that is A dash, what you have marked on the XY line, the radius what you have set it for the side, what they have given, which is 55 millimeter. Now with the A dash as a center, with the radius equal to 55 millimeter, so you cut the projector line, the axis line, the axis, from the axis you have projected, right? The projector line which has been projected from the axis, you cut this. Okay, so now you will get the point O dash. I will repeat once again, after marking all the points on the XY line, the projector points on the XY line, so extend the axis projector. Extend the axis projector from O1 dash beyond the XY line to a certain length. Beyond the XY line to a certain length. Now take a compass. Set the radius of the compass equal to the side of the tetrahedron. So in this case, the side of the tetrahedron is 55 millimeter. So therefore, you have to set the radius equal to 55 millimeter. Now you have to select the point on the XY line of the front view, which is to be selected only the projector line which comes from the corner point. Okay, so corner in this case is A here. Okay, so B and C is an edge. So don't take the projector point from the edge for edge point. Take it from the corner point. So because this is the only the slant edge OA which parallel to VP and HP and get the true length of this slant edge. So therefore, select the point A dash. Okay, and with the A dash as a center and radius equal to 55 millimeter, using a compass, draw an arc which cuts the projected line for the axis. So it cuts at a point, you just mark it as an O dash. Got it? So now you join from O dash to A dash, which is 55 millimeters. Then O dash to B dash and C dash, the point what you marked on the XY line. Then join A dash and B dash. Okay, from O1 dash, draw the axis to O dash. So this is the completion of the front view. Okay, front view of a tetrahedron. So this is the initial position of a tetrahedron, which is resting on one of its corners on H. Okay, so are you following? If you have any clarification, you can stop me at any point. Okay, because tetrahedrons are very important from the examination point of view. So definitely they will be keep on asking one batch tetrahedron, definitely it will be there. Okay, so if you have any clarification, you can stop me. Okay. Tetrahedron is very important from the examination point of view. So understand the initial position, you can stop. So once the initial position, the second position is the edge, the edge which is containing that corner is the rest. The resting corner is A. Okay, the edge containing that corner is OA. Okay, so in the sense, in the front view, you can see it as O dash and A dash. O dash, A dash is the edge which is containing corner A. So now this edge containing the corner is inclined to HP at 50 degrees. Okay, this is what this is. So now what you have to do in the second position, so you have to tilt the tetrahedron such that the edge O dash and A dash takes an angle of 50 degrees with respect to HP. So how do you do that? So first you mark the point on the X, on the XY line. So that is A dash, because you are tilting on the corner. So mark the point A dash on the XY line. Okay. Now draw a line for 50 degrees, because the edge is inclined to HP at 50 degrees. So draw a line for 50 degrees measuring in the anti-clockwise direction. Now with measure the distance of O dash and A dash. So O dash, A dash is, of course, it is 55 millimeters. So now with A dash as a center, what you have marked on the XY line to a convenient distance, with O dash at the center, so the line what you have drawn in the second position for 50 degrees, you cut an arc on that line and that you mark that as an O dash. Join O dash and A dash and draw a very thick line. Join O dash, A dash with a thick line. So represent the angle of inclination of that edge, which is 50 degrees. Okay, so now you have to construct the remaining triangle. So A dash and O dash, 2 points you have got. So next, you just have to construct the entire the front view, which is a triangle, O dash, B dash and A dash. Now with the reference as O dash and A dash, take the convenient distance to get the B dash. So taking a compass, using a compass, measure O dash, B dash, A dash, B dash and O dash, B dash. So with the compass, you construct this and complete the front. So second position, front view. So where you are inclining the tetrahedron such that the edge containing that corner making an angle of 50 degrees with respect to HP. So this is the second position front view, where you are satisfying the condition of the edge containing the corner is inclined to HP at 50 degrees. Okay, so once you complete this, the next thing is you have to get the corresponding top view, second position top view. So how to get the top view now? Just draw the projectors from each points of view, these two. And similarly from the corresponding initial position top view, you get the second position top view. So drawing the projectors from the second position front view and corresponding project us from the initial position of view, and first you mark the points across the intersections. So across the intersections you mark O, A, B, C. So all these four points, and of course O1 also. So you mark all those points first. Before you join, first you mark the points where all these will go into intersect. Okay. After that, now you have to apply the rules of visibility. So where you are observing the tetrahedron from the top. Okay. So where, when you just observe from the top, you can see the triangular face, the top triangular face, which is O dash, B dash, and then another one is C dash. O dash, B dash, C dash is visible in the top view. Whereas the point A dash, the corner A dash, is away from the observer, and hence the edges which arises out of A dash in the top view will be an invisible edges. Okay, what are the possible edges which comes out of, provided if it is not possible, if it is not, does not forms an outline of a solid. So the possible edges are A dash is nothing but A dash and B dash, A dash and C dash, as well as A dash and O dash. So these are possible edges which are going to arise from A dash. So therefore, if you look at this top view over here, the top triangular face O dash O E C. This triangular face is completely visible for us. Okay, so the edges which comes out of A dash, which is A dash and B dash, that is AB and AC and OA, all these three are not visible in the top view. So join all these edges OA, AB and AC with a thick dashed lines. This is the incident edge representation. Okay, and of course we have axis over here. So axis we cannot show because invisible edge is there. So you can show the invisible edge instead of an axis. So this is the complete of the second position of a tetrahedron, which is resting on it, and edge is inclined to which we have. Okay. Once you complete the second position, then the third condition that needs to be satisfied is the edge which is already inclined to HP at 50 degrees, then again it is inclined to VP at 30 degrees. The same edge, the edge O dash and A dash, what it is being inclined to HP at 50 degrees. The same edge is also inclined to VP at 30 degrees. So now what happens in the second position is, since in the initial position front view, it is a true length, O dash and A dash is 55 millimeter, right? So now we have taken the same thing in the second position front view, but when it is been projected for the top view, right? So here we are having the length of the edge OA. The length of the edge OA are nothing but the edge which containing that corner. The length of the edge which containing that corner OA has been not the true length. It is an apparent length because you are observing from the top. So look at here. This is 55 millimeter O dash and A dash. Now you are projecting it into the top. Right? See, this is the apparent length. This is the length of the edge which containing that corner, which length is always been reduced, and hence we call it as an apparent length. Okay, so this apparent length is now the same edge is to be inclined to VP at 30 degrees. So just go back to the problems what we solved in the solids. So where the axis is already inclined to HP, the same axis is inclined to be used to do, used to take the beta angle. So here also the problem is you have to take it as a beta angle. Please be careful with the background. Okay, so here the edge already inclined to HP at 50 degrees. is again it has been made to incline to VP at 30 degrees. So in such cases, we have to go for beta angle. Be careful. Okay. So the same procedure how we used to do for the same procedure you can apply over. So how we can do? So the angle of inclination with this is mark the true length of the edge which containing the corner A dash or P. So 30 degree line you are drawn. So first mark the point O. Okay. So now what is the true length of the edge containing the corner? It is 55, right? So this is can be obtained from the second, so initial position, which is nothing but 55 meters. What is the same? The line what you are drawn, 30 degree line, and you are marked O, right? With O as a center, the line is equal to the true length of the edge, that is O dash and A dash, that is 55 meters. You cut the 30 degree line. Cut the 30 degree line. That you get as a point in the intersection of cuts the 30 degree line at the wood. Now from the wood, you draw and so draw the locus. Once you draw the next what you sure the apparent edge that you get as a O. So now it will be the up and down the H A. Now with the first step, you cut the locus line what you have drawn from O to that. Okay. So join point where you have cut that as an A. So that is OA. Okay. So now join OA. The dash now this is a reference. This is the and inclination this particular the pitch it is given. So now with OA as the trans line, now we have trans second. Keeping OA as a reference, the entire second position top view has been transferred to the third position or third position. And because just trying to so using a compass, you can transfer the entire second position top view to the third top view. The reference at after doing this, what we do is we have get the support from each and Hello, can you hear me? Hello.
So your voice is not audible.
Now?
The sound's breaking.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Just the same what I have.